Melz on the MIC.
Excuse me while I whip this out.
Today's R&B and throwbacks. MyKiss 103.1.
It's today's R&B and throwbacks. MyKiss 103.1 inside your Friday night dance party. Melz on the MIC in the building, and I'm joined by a big guest, the big star in the building with me tonight. What's going on,
What's
my brother?
What's up, man? I'm good, man. Happy to be here, man.
Flex Alexander's in the building.
Yes, sir. Not Flex Washington.
I see. Whoever that was posted this man's name as Flex Washington, you're dead wrong. It's Flex Alexander. He's in the building. What's good, my brother?
I'm good, man. Just here, man. Three big shows at the Laugh It Up Comedy Lounge, man. Looking forward to it. Just really going back to what I love, going back to stand up. That's what I started in 89 and took time off, you know, when I started doing one on one and, you know, had my family and everything. And I said, you know what, it's time to get back at it, you know, because it's the only thing really that I can use my own voice. You know what I mean? Like scripted television and all that, you're doing characters. But this right here, I can just talk about what's on my mind. So I'm excited.
So what's on your mind lately, then?
Just now, I'm talking about everything. I'm talking about, you know, marriage, sex, kids, losing everything. You know what I mean? Materially. You know, as you saw on the show. Flex and Shanice on the OWN Network. Talking about it all, man. Talking about it all. Talking about, you know, weed, everything.
No doubt.
It's 420.
It is 420. Happy 420. You know, because, you know, potheads don't tend to remember days of the week. I'm just saying. But they do remember 420. They do remember this day.
That's right.
But let's talk about that because, you know, you've been through a lot. You've been through the Hollywood ringer and all that other stuff.
Yeah.
And especially you married to a pop star.
Yes.
Well, a music star.
Yes.
And something we talked about earlier this week when I interviewed you earlier. Shanice is getting ready to go back in the studio real quick and work on some new
music. Now. Yeah.
But how has it been? Because there was much publicized about your fallout with y'all finances and stuff
that. Yeah.
But you guys also been showing how you can get back on your feet.
And
tell the audience about that.
I mean, you know, we decided to do the show because we wanted to show people that, look, we celebrities, whatever, we go through the same things that everyday people go through. And we're everyday people. Like,
exactly.
I don't do all the, I'm home. You know what I'm saying? I go do what I have to do, work, whatever, and I'm home. Mm-hmm. You know, I drive my kids to school, you know, every morning. So I'm involved.
Right.
We just went through a time where we thought we were doing what was smart. Like I thought, I said, we're going to invest in real estate, invested in massive real estate, but in the wrong state, in Vegas. And in 2008, when the cover was lifted off of everybody in America, we just got caught in that, man.
Right.
Yo, and I was trying to carry those mortgages for 4 years myself. So I'm pulling from savings and I'm trying to carry it because of the fact you think, and if you lose everything, it's like, yo, it's embarrassing and all that. But it just got to the point where I just couldn't do it. And I just had to let it go.
Right.
And it is what it is.
Right.
You know, and I don't care. And we just wanted to show people that you can go through that, you can rebuild, and you can bounce back.
No doubt. And it's a great story. And that's why we like to see. And I know the folks are going to be looking forward to hearing not only that story, but some more stories tonight at the Laugh It Up Comedy Lounge. This weekend, three shows. You're in the building for that.
Yes, sir.
Make sure you get details about it right now on our website at mykiss1031.com. Also at the laughitupcomedylounge.com. And also at the Laugh It Up Comedy Lounge box office.
See, a lot of people forgot or didn't know that I started in stand-up.
I see folks here in the comments right now on our Facebook page. Somebody said, "Lord Flex still fine." Look, I'm gonna need y'all to stop thirst trapping. This man is married. Stop it. DJ Ladybug says, "Def Comedy Jam. I got a package for Flex."
Oh, okay. Yes, Def Comedy Jam. I was one of the originals on Def Comedy Jam.
Some of these folks know.
Yeah, yeah. But it's, you know, I'm talking about in this new era now, which you got the social media, the millennials. It's different. You know, these younger comedians, you know, you're going out trying to book shows and you got, you know, promoters saying, send me a tape on your stuff. And I'm like, what? I mean, your mother was a fan of mine. So, you know what I mean? I got to realize they were babies when I was doing stand-up.
Right.
You know, I started stand-up in 89.
Right.
I came up with Martin Lawrence, Chris Rock, like under those guys. Mm-hmm. So I've seen the best and the greatest. So now that transition into fitting in with this millennial age.
Right.
You know what I mean? I won't say it's been difficult, but it's just been different.
Right. And that's what I was going to ask. How has it been different? Because I know you see a lot of guys now, they're getting on just by Instagram and Facebook.
Yeah. And I'm not saying all of them, but some of them, they get on you know, by doing a minute worth of comedy or sketch, but then they can't do 20 minutes of comedy. You know what I mean? I think for me, it's just been being more active, social media. But I come from the school of, you know, you had to really work to be famous.
The gatekeepers.
Yeah, it wasn't no joke. You know, I'm doing shows up and down Highway 95, going to colleges. I mean, working every day in New York. You know, I could do 3-4 shows a night. So it was just a different vibe. But now, you just have to, because I'm not one, I'm never going to be that angry, you know, older dude, like, man, they ain't doing nothing.
Right.
I'm just like, okay, I understand it. Let me figure out how to, you know, work myself into it and just give things from my perspective as, you know, I turned 48 April 15th.
Right.
So my whole view is different. You know what I mean? I'm trying to figure out how do I incorporate that into what's going on now.
Okay. You know what I mean? And trust me, y'all going to be looking forward to it this weekend. Laughing Up Comedy Lounge. Don't forget to get your tickets this weekend. Killeen is stepping the game up. That's right. You know we've been stepping the game up out here in the K because we got all the stars in the building now, man. This is what we got going on in the CTAs. Yes, and plus, yes, they got me out here in the country. My station is next to a train station. So yes, you will hear the train. I don't know why they positioned me next to a train track for some strange reason. That's how they do me too.
That's all right.
Well, thank you, Lisa. I appreciate it. I am fine. Thank you so much. I don't want no trouble, though. I don't want no smoke. Anyway, it's time. Well, before we get you out of here, because we want to make sure that you know, get some rest before you get your show started tonight. I want to play a game with you.
Okay,
ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for the game that we all love to play. I call it, what are you searching for?
Okay.
Now, when you go to Google, you type in your name, Flex Alexander.
Right.
Google will try to predict the next four things that people are searching for you.
Right.
So these are basically the four things people are searching for the most about you.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I got the answers.
Oh, God.
I want you to guess.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
So proceed. What do you think people are searching for about you?
Net worth.
That is incorrect.
Oh, dang.
That is incorrect. They don't want to know how much money you got. They know y'all ain't got no money, man. Stop.
See? No, but because of that, people do that. They go search because of what happened.
Okay, but that's not one of
okay,
them.
Okay, okay, Michael Jackson movie?
Woo, wrong. We gonna talk about that too.
Yeah, man. Hey, that check was great. That check was great.
That's okay. We'll talk about that.
2004, 175K went a long way.
That is, you're two. You're over two now.
Gosh.
Think in simpler terms. Think in simpler terms.
Of my family, my kids.
I'll accept. One of the answers is brother.
Brother.
Yes. They want to know if you have a brother.
Oh, okay.
So I'll accept that.
Yes. Boom. Okay, thank you. Good. I got one.
I'll accept that.
I have several brothers. Yes.
Okay. One more. You're one for three.
How old I am.
How old are you? That is correct.
Oh,
two for four. They want to know how old you are.
All right.
So
all
that's
right.
Two for four. You came close.
All right, man.
You still have to get a penalty shot. But I don't have any liquor today. I'm sorry. I didn't go to the liquor store. I didn't get the penalty shot today.
Penalty shot, but he got some Hawaiian barbecue sauce.
I ought to make you take that. Some spicy teriyaki sauce over here. I got it for you. Well, the four answers are one is Blue Bloods.
Okay.
Were you on that show?
Yeah, I was the original partner for Donnie Wahlberg, and what happened was they, I guess, talked about it, the network. They wanted him to have sexual tension with his partner, and I said, I could do a lot of things, but I can't give you that. So they brought in a female partner.
Gotcha. Okay. Uh-huh. The second one was age.
Uh-huh.
The third one was brother.
Uh-huh.
And the fourth one is kind of weird, but it's TV show.
Okay.
TV show.
Right.
We know you'd have been in a bunch of TV shows.
Yeah, yeah.
Lots of TV shows.
Right.
I always bring up Homeboys and Outer Space.
Hey, man. Hey, let me tell you something. At 26 years old when I did that, so I was making $35 a week.
Look.
I took it.
Look, that was UPN, right?
Yes.
Look, we love that damn show.
Hey, you know the thing is, the thing is that we got to stop doing, our people, man. I love us, but we complain when we don't have it.
Exactly.
And then when we get it and
don't support it,
it's gone.
Absolutely.
You ain't never heard Bette Midler calling Barbara Streisand a trick. You know what I mean? Or she ain't really dope. She can't really say. They don't do that. They don't do it. They're about getting that bread.
Right, exactly.
Or as Stevie J says, that bread.
But don't forget, Flex Alexander this weekend at the Laughing Up Comedy Lounge, man. It's going to be crazy, man. I'll leave you alone about the Michael Jackson movie. Because all you had to say was the check.
The check. I said, how much? I was like, I'll be there. Thank you. This is amazing. I'm so happy to be there.
But my only question I have was about it was, what? How much study did you put into it?
You know, what happened was, originally they told me, hey, we're going to have all the rights to all the music, everything. So it was going to be authorized.
Right.
I'm like, cool. 2 weeks into shooting, they called me into a meeting. I'm like, this is some bull. the lawyers. I'm like, all right, cool. Then I knew we was in trouble. But right. I did, you know, a lot of research. I was already a Michael Jackson fan.
I used to do him,
you know, sketches and, you know, back in the day, Uptown Comedy Club. So, you know, I was like, all right, cool. So I, as a whole TV guy, all the critics said my performance, they were cool with. Mm-hmm. It was the production value and everything else around it. Mm-hmm. We shot it in Canada. It was great people, but it was things that I had problems with. Right. But, you know, I was like, how much? how much?
How much?
I'll take it. This is before social media. So now social media, these kids be like tweeting, you going to hell for doing that to the King of Pop. Because they think I just shot it like last year.
Right.
I had fun, man. And you know.
And before we get out, one more thing about one-on-one. We talked about this on the show.
Yes.
You say you was getting ready for a possible reboot.
Yes, I'm sitting down with one of the producers who I pitched the show to. A lot of people don't know I created the show.
Mm-hmm.
One of the producers, I'm sitting down with him next week. And we're going to start talking about it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Man, we're looking forward to that, man. We're going to be so excited
Kyle
for it, man.
Kyle's down. I interviewed her on my radio show, and she's down. And everybody else is, they ready to go if it happens.
No doubt, man. Yeah. Go ahead and plug the radio show, man. No Flex Zone.
No Flex Zone every Thursday from 7 to 9 Pacific Standard Time, only on Dash Radio. We just interviewed Tevin Campbell before I left. We've had Method Man, Kid from Kid and Play. It's just a fun time, man. We mix classic hip hop with our guests, talk about their favorite songs, and you know, the soundtrack to our life, man.
No doubt.
You know what I mean? So I have fun. So I, what you do is something that I know it ain't easy. Trust me, I've learned.
I learned.
Everybody calls me, yo, man, I want to be on the show, man. Like, I did a play. You know what I mean?
Trust me. Hey, once you get into this side of the game, everybody thinks it's just you just yapping on the microphone. I've been trying to tell y'all it's way more than that.
It's way more. Especially with them bills to pay the sponsors.
Thank you. Thank you. But Flex Alexander, this weekend, Laugh It Up Comedy Lounge.
Come out.
Three shows.
Yes.
Get your tickets now. KilleenLaughLounge.com, LaughItUpComedyLounge.com. Also at the Laugh It Up Comedy Lounge box office. Three shows this weekend.
Yes, sir.
Kicking off tonight, 9 o'clock.
Yes, sir.
And then Saturday night.
Yes, sir.
What time are you on Saturday?
Hey, Daryl. Daryl back there ordering food. Huh?
Seven tomorrow.
Sunday is 7. Tomorrow, I think it's 8. 8
okay.
or 9.
Okay.
Yeah, you know, Dad will just be throwing me to the wolves, man.
Well, you're going to be all right, because the city's going to show y'all some love. So don't forget, go get tickets this weekend. Thank you for checking in, though, man. Thank you for stopping by, brother.
Thank you. Thank
I really
you
do appreciate
all
it, man.
Right,
thank
man.
You.
Definitely.
Once again, Flex Alexander in the CTX this weekend at the Laugh It Up Comedy Lounge. Go see him. Show him some love, CTX.
Today's R&B and throwbacks. My Kiss, 103.1.